The woman everyone is waiting for in 2016, of course, is Hillary Rodham Clinton. Also spoke to Barbara Walters, and she too didn't completely rule herself out for running for president. Let's watch the Secretary of State.
I've said I really don't believe that's something I will do again.
You know your husband wants you to run in 2016. What do you say to him?
He wants me to do what I want to do, and he has made that very clear. And some of what I want to do is just kick back. I mean, it sounds...
Yeah, but after you have slept...
Well,
kick back,
but I haven't had the chance to do that yet.
So well, let's give you 3 months.
Oh, no.
What would it take to convince you to run in 2016?
You know, that's all hypothetical. Because right now I have no intention of running.
One thing, Bob, no candidate, male or female, Democrat or Republican, ever admits to is ambition. It's not in their memoirs. When they're 90 years old and about to die, they never admit it. They never admit it when they're 25 years old. Ambition is the one thing you never admit, but everybody knows you have. It's the weirdest thing about politics. I'm only doing it for children, only doing it for old people, only doing it for somebody else or world peace. They never say, I want to be president. Now, when you watch Hillary Clinton, I do believe she hasn't made up her mind, but do you take that as an acting role later when she says, I haven't thought about it, or do you take it for real?
Oh, I think she thinks about it. And when people say they don't intend to run, that's usually a signal that they're going to run.
Look, she could surprise us. They're going to intend to run.
she could surprise us and decide not to run. I don't think that's going to happen. I think there's a very good chance that she will run. She's a very formidable candidate this time. Women will overwhelmingly support her, number one. Number two, she have tremendous financial advantage. And number three, Chris, she's a lot better off running not for a Clinton restoration, but much more in her own right, having been Secretary of State as a successor to Obama and out there articulating the kind of populist themes that worked so well for her at the end of the primaries in 2008 and which have now become central for the president.
Yeah, I agree. By the way, every time I have a poll at a dinner party or at lunch with a bunch of people, I ask, do you think she's going to run? And everybody thinks it's unanimous till you ask them. It's usually a slight majority thinks she's going to run. It's never a big majority. People really have second thought because they know it's a 12-year run you're talking about.
Right.
4 years running, 8 years serving. It's a really brutal road she's setting for herself. I think she'll run, but I don't think it's an easy decision.
And I think she's exhausted. I mean,
I think she ought to do what she said she's going to do.
Being in that public
life that long. Do nothing for 3 months.
I think that's right. And, you know, she's going to be a tough candidate. There's no doubt about it.
Nobody can beat her. I don't think.
No, well, I think it depends what the economy is.
Maybe your guy, Christie.
I think
we'll have you back for Christie when you're
I think Jeb Bush could beat him.
You'll be his press secretary. Thank you, Bob. You'll be press secretary for Christie. By the way, that would be a great job if you could speak for him. None of your business. The governor says none of your business. The governor says none of your business. Every day you say it all day long. Anyway, thank you, Bob Shrum. Thank you, John Kerry.
Now here is your first look at this morning's dish of scrambled politics. Actress Meryl Streep and Secretary of State Hillary Clinton were having way too much fun at a State Department gala Saturday night, part of this weekend's Kennedy Center Honors Celebration. And speaking of Clinton, you can add one more name to the list of people convinced that she is running for president in 2016. New Yorker magazine editor David Remnick came to that conclusion after attending the Saban Forum Friday night, which featured Clinton. He says she was in, quote, high political gear.
Hillary Clinton is ending her job as the Secretary of State, but if history is any guide, we're not going to be seeing the last of her by any means. CNN's Randy Kaye is joining us. She's got some details. Randy, tell our viewers what's going on.
Well, Wolf, as you know, there was quite a bit of drama playing out on Capitol Hill today. You saw it yourself. At times, Hillary Clinton close to tears. Other times, she looked pretty enraged. But drama and controversy, certainly nothing new for her. She has seen it all. This is not the first time Hillary Clinton seemed to say goodbye.
I am determined to leave the State Department and our country safer, stronger, and more secure.
When you just knew she'd be back to say hello. She launched herself back in the days of the nerdy circular glasses as the woman who could take tradition and crack it like a nut. She and Bill Clinton met and fell in love at Yale. Then in 1974, she moved to Arkansas to teach, making partner at the Rose Law Firm 5 years later. She kept working after her husband was elected governor of Arkansas. She would become the first lady to do so.
I suppose I could have stayed home and baked cookies and had tea.
Then came Washington.
This health security card will represent a right of every citizen, and it will give each of us the security of knowing we will be taken care of when we need help.
Her health care initiative came crashing down in 1994. Her high visibility came at a cost, But the superwoman learned to steel herself in the face of repeated controversy. There was the unexplained suicide of White House counsel Vince Foster and questions about the Clintons' Whitewater land deal. But the challenges didn't end there.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Ms. Lewinsky.
The affair and the House vote after that to impeach her husband threatened to derail Team Clinton. But Hillary was nothing if not resilient. She ran for Congress and was elected senator from New York with 56% of the vote. She became the first First Lady to enter Congress. And in 2007, another first.
When people tell me, well, you know, I don't think a woman can be elected president, I said, well, I don't believe that, but we're going to find out.
She became Hillary, like Shakira or Cher. It showed independence. It was a hard-fought campaign against Barack Obama, but Hillary never backed down.
Shame on you, Barack Obama.
Even when campaigning got ugly. Not long after that, Clinton welled up at the New Hampshire diner and ran away with the primary, another victory. But in the end, she conceded, wrapping up her historic presidential bid.
Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time.
But her persistence and passion convinced the man she tried to beat to cast her on the world stage.
In her, you will have a Secretary of State who has my full confidence.
The former First Lady and Senator from New York would become Madam Secretary in 2009. Yet now, a millionaire miles and 112 countries later, she finds herself entangled in one final controversy.
I'm in charge of the State Department, 60,000 plus people all over the world, 275 posts.
Testifying about who knew what when, in light of the attack on the compound in Benghazi. But if history is any guide, Hillary Clinton may emerge unscathed once again and reinvent herself.
And Hillary's close friends say when it comes to her future, she isn't rushing to make any decisions, Wolf. She is not going to do this on anyone else's timetable. And that sounds just like Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, she did not back down at all during, what, 5.5 hours of testimony before the House and Senate committees. Excellent work. Thanks very much, Randy, for that report.
Hillary Clinton will be sitting down with President Obama today for their first ever joint interview, which is scheduled to air on Sunday. Who would have thought that 4 years ago? They have been 4 successful years for her, but now she's getting ready to step down as Secretary of State.
We're all getting a little emotional and sentimental around here with about a little over a week to go in my tenure.
Secretary Clinton made those comments during the launch of a nonprofit organization yesterday, capping off a busy but also contentious week. You couldn't help but notice during her grueling day of questions on Capitol Hill Wednesday just how savvy she was, deferential to some senators, combative with others, perhaps with an eye on 2016. Joining me now is White House Managing Editor for National Journal, Matthew Cooper. Good to see you, Matthew. Good morning.
Thanks, Chris.
First, let me ask you about the Clinton-Obama 60 Minutes interview. Politico notes it will be not only the first joint interview for the two, but it's also the first sit-down TV interview the president has given with anyone but Michelle Obama. So how big a deal is this, and what should we be looking for, do you think?
Well, I think you'll want to look at the body language between them. I think they'll, you know, they've developed a great working relationship after battling each other in the 2008 campaign. And I think you'll look for them to project a very strong message to the world, especially Iran, North Korea, and other perceived threats around the globe.
Yeah, you know that they're going to ask him, would you vote for her in 2016? So that's the question I'm waiting for. Let's talk about Secretary Clinton's testimony on Benghazi. You write this would be her last scandal, with scandal in quotation marks. Talk about that, Matthew.
Well, you know, ever since she and Bill Clinton got to Washington in 1993, there's been one scandal, in quotation marks, after another, most of which have proven to be not really scandalous at all. There was, you know, the suicide of her friend and former law partner Vince Foster, who's the White House counsel. Big investigation into whether anything nefarious happened there. Turned out it was nothing but his very sad depression. You know, Whitewater. Lots of other things, you know, just didn't really pan out in a way that stopped her from going on to be elected twice as a U.S. Senator from New York and from nearly getting the Democratic nomination in 2008 and being Secretary of State. So my point in the piece in National Journal was that if you keep you know, crying wolf essentially about someone, it's very hard for the, you know, 39th time you do it for it to stick.
Not only that, but she's obviously gotten very practiced at how to deal with these kinds of situations. Although she did become emotional when talking about those killed in the Benghazi consulate, including Ambassador Chris Stevens. Let me play that.
For me, this is not just a matter of policy, it's personal. I stood next to President Obama as the Marines carried those flag-draped caskets off the plane at Andrews. I put my arms around the mothers and fathers, the sisters and brothers, the sons and daughters, and the wives left alone to raise their children.
And then Senator Ron Johnson, who she had a fire exchange with later, suggested maybe she faked her emotion to avoid answering his questions, just as some suggested she was faking her illness when she actually ended up in the hospital. Is this sort of anti-Hillary 2016 already underway?
It's certainly, you know, anti-Hillary. I don't think it really behooved the Republicans well to go down that particular road. They never really got a good narrative line on the Benghazi tragedy. First, they kind of suggested that the administration had covered up the origins of the tragedy in order to somehow help them in the election. That always had odd logic to me, because normally an attack on Americans might actually help the incumbent party. Be that as it may, then their argument kind of morphed into incompetence. They never really sort of had a argument they were driving towards yesterday, and thus, for that reason, many others, especially Secretary Clinton appointing a blue ribbon panel to investigate the tragedy in Benghazi, she came out pretty well.
Yeah, and let me ask you finally, because we're all looking ahead to see will she or won't she in 2016. How have you these last 4 years not just changed her, but changed the kind of candidate she would be and her prospects for winning this time around?
Well, I think it's only enhanced a blue chip resume. You know, I mean, the two, elections from New York for Senate capped a very long run and unique path-breaking run as First Lady. I think she's gotten wide praise for her, helm at the State Department. So it's really raised her from being a big national figure to a truly global figure. And so if she decides at close to age 70 that she wants to run, she'll obviously be a very, very formidable candidate.
You want to place bets? What do you think the chances are?
At the Defense Department today, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was awarded the Pentagon's highest recognition for public service by the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Martin Dempsey, and Defense Secretary Leon Panetta. Clinton thanked the group for her Valentine's Day gift. We should note also, for the first time since her accident in December, Clinton did not have to wear those corrective lenses she'd been using for impaired vision from her fall.
In the years ahead, we will be looking to all of you and to your successors to carry this mission of American leadership forward, to keep our nation strong, free, and exceptional. I am so grateful that we've had a chance to contribute in each of our ways to making our country and our world stronger, safer, fairer, and better.
But as CNN political editor Paul Steinhauser explains, the hot topic is what could happen in 4 years.
Hey, Miguel. You know, it's the biggest question in presidential politics. Will she run? The she, of course, is now former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. When asked at a global town hall a few days ago if she was thinking of making another bid for the White House, this was her answer.
I am not thinking about anything like that right now.
And here's what she said the same day in an interview with CNN.
Have you decided that you absolutely will not run?
Well, I have absolutely no plans to run.
No plans, but she isn't closing the door. Clinton's returning to private life with some poll numbers any politician would love. Nearly 7 in 10 in a recent NBC Wall Street Journal poll said they approved of the job she was doing as America's top diplomat. And 2/3 in a recent ABC Washington Post survey said they had a favorable impression of her. Clinton shouldn't be in any rush to make up her mind, says Democratic strategist and CNN contributor Paul Begala, who was a top political advisor to President Bill Clinton.
She's not going to commit to running when I think in her heart she has not decided to. And she's got the time, she's got the support. There's no need to rush into 2016.
If she does run, Our own CNN ORC poll indicates the obvious. She'd be the front runner for the Democratic presidential nomination. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's let Clinton enjoy some downtime, at least for a month or two.
Hillary Clinton gave a lot of CEOs a reason to believe that they could compete.
Exactly. You know, this is essentially about Hillary Clinton negotiating what it means to be Secretary of State in a time when the U.S. is arguably more economically vulnerable than it's ever been. And she comes into office, and one of the first things she and her aides told me was that she saw, you know, all these foreign heads of state going to bat for their companies. You know, Angela Merkel taking almost 24 CEOs to China. You know, you can't imagine President Obama doing that.
Right.
So she's looking at this and saying, well, what can I do? You know, I'm a former presidential candidate, first lady, senator, I'm a superstar, and what can I do? And, you know, then it turns out that she has gone to bat for dozens of companies and helped them seal billions of dollars worth of deals.
There's one thing Democrats and Republicans can agree on. As of today, Hillary Clinton would be an unstoppable candidate if she runs for president in 2016.
Elise, you travel with the Secretary of State, you watch her work, you see the pace she keeps. This is a tireless woman, not used to slowing down.
Definitely not, Don. This is a woman who we can't even keep up with her. There's the pace that she goes, especially on the road, but also here in Washington, is really relentless. There is, it's not someone who just flies and meets in a foreign ministry with a leader or a president and has a dinner. This is someone who's constantly going on the road, meeting with civil society groups, meeting with opposition groups, having town halls. Someone who really doesn't slow down. And, you know, the last few years, Secretary Clinton always has been someone that keeps a frantic pace, even when she was first lady, when she was senator. But the last few years, Don, she's really been going at a kind of frantic pace. They call her the ever-ready bunny.
After logging more than 950,000 miles, visiting 112 countries, Hillary Clinton is known for keeping a grueling schedule and enjoys something rarely seen anymore in politics, a huge approval rating, close to 70%.
She is tireless and extraordinary.
It's because I think she works hard, she does a good job, she really cares, she authentically cares, and she has, I think, devoted her whole life to this set of issues.
You know, the journalists that travel with her can't even keep up with her. She's always, you know, got some other group to visit, some other place to go, some other event. And sometimes we could travel to three countries in a day. I mean, this is someone who really puts the pedal to the metal. I think just the pace of the last 4 months, you know, everyone's been wondering, is she going to run for president in 2016? And when you ask her whether she's going to, she says, I mean, a lot of people don't necessarily believe her, but she says no. And I think one of the things is that even if she believes it right now, I think a lot of people think she just needs some rest, she needs to slow down. And there have been people that have been worried about the kind of the pace that she's taking, because this is not someone who's saying, no, I can't do that. This is someone who, to her staff, is saying, come on, we can fit one more thing in, we can fit one more meeting in, we can fit one more country in. Sometimes I travel to three countries in a day with Secretary Clinton.
She is hugely popular, both here and abroad. When asked today about the number of goodwill get well messages the Secretary Clinton has been sent following her illness, a spokeswoman at the State Department said it has been a tsunami of messages.
Yeah, she's very popular, not only in the United States, but around the world.
Absolutely right.
And she's been, I think, to almost every country in the world.
Paul Begala even told me today he thinks she's the most recognizable face, female face, especially coming from our country around the world.
Yeah, well, we wish her the best.
We do.
Well, Secretary Clinton was, you know, as you well know, she really moved. She was constantly on the go. She never stopped. She went to all these countries. I think she broke all sorts of records. I know that Madeleine Albright and Condoleezza Rice and Colin Powell, they traveled a lot as Secretary of State. But I think Hillary Clinton broke all sorts of records, and she worked really hard. And I had a chance to spend a little time on one of those trips. She went to France, then Egypt, then Tunisia. I accompanied her on her plane, watched what was going on. She was nonstop. She took that kind of aggressive, nonstop travel from her, to a certain degree from her husband, the former President Bill Clinton. I traveled with him all the time, and he was nonstop as well. He used to do day trips. We used to joke to Bosnia or Kosovo or whatever, and Hillary Clinton was like that. She moved.
And we know as well, Secretary Clinton, when she was the First Lady, traveled quite a bit as well around the world.
A lot going on today. Here are some things we thought you should know. President Obama, Hillary Clinton are the most admired man and woman in the world. According to an annual Gallup poll, this is the 11th year in a row that Hillary Clinton has topped the most admired list.
Well, Hillary Clinton says she insists that she wants to get out of politics.
Huh.
But a new poll is showing that the majority of Americans are hoping she has a change of heart. The latest ABC News Washington Post poll shows 57% of Americans would vote for Hillary Clinton in 2016. Hillary Clinton also has a strong bit of support in her home state of New York, where 54% of voters say she'd make a great runner. But New Yorkers aren't so enthusiastic about the current governor jumping to the race. Just 39% support Andrew Cuomo's 2016 presidential bid.
Also, it was back to work Monday for Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, and her warm welcome is our favorite story of the day. There it is.
That's right. After a month of health problems, including a fall, a concussion, and a blood clot, Clinton got a standing ovation from about 75 staffers at the State Department.
And they had a little fun at her expense, too, which I thought was kind of funny. They gave her a few presents, a helmet, actually, with the State Department seal on it, and also a football jersey with her name and the number 112, as you see right there. That's the number of countries she has visited as Secretary of State. Almost a million miles traveled in that job. The most traveled Secretary of State in the history of the country.
Tom Nides gave her, you see there, regulation helmet, football helmet stamped with the State Department seal, because of course life in Washington is in fact a contact sport. And to make the uniform complete, a jersey with the words Clinton and 112 and the number 112. That's of course the number of countries that Secretary Clinton has visited as Secretary of State, a world indoor and outdoor record.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us. TeHillaryClinton.com.
Cause you're amazing, just the way you are. And when you smile, the whole world stops and stares for a while. Cause girl, you're amazing, just the way you are. Yeah.
Quite an accomplishment. And today, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton made her first public comment since returning to work after treatment for a concussion and blood clot in her head. She's leaving the State Department soon, but sidestepped a question about retirement.
It's, obviously somewhat bittersweet because I've had the most extraordinary experience and I work with just an amazing team of people. But I'm very much looking forward to doing everything we can these last few weeks to resolve and finish up wherever possible, and then to, you know, have a very smooth, seamless transition to Senator Kerry to continue the work.
And then retiring?
Well, I don't know if that's the word I would use, but certainly stepping off the very fast track for a little while.
We shall see.
Last night, President Obama said goodbye and thank you to Hillary Clinton, and he chose to do it quietly on 60 Minutes, knowing that that would create even more talk about Hillary running for president in 2016. Which is what we're going to do next.
As deep as, yes, the GOP bench?
Absolutely. It's strange. I think Hillary Clinton is by far the most likely nominee for either party to be the presidential nominee in 2016. Republicans have a lot of sort of B candidates or B minus candidates who are very interesting. Yeah. Democrats have none. I mean, is it Antonio Villaraigosa? I don't really. Is it Debbie Wasserman Schultz? I don't think so. Joe Biden? I mean, I think people are delusional.
America's happy warrior.
He's a super happy warrior. He's been running for president for 1,000 years. He's not going to win, right? So I think the Democrats have a bench problem right now, and it's serious, but they do have a clear front runner, I think.
All right. Thank you so much.
I am very proud to have been Secretary of State. I will miss you.
I will probably be dialing ops just to talk. I will wonder what you all are doing, because I know that because of your efforts day after day, we are making a real difference. But I leave this department confident.
Just moments ago, Hillary Clinton formally wrapped up her run as Secretary of State, the most traveled in history. She said a final farewell to her State Department colleagues, although there really aren't that many out there who believe she has said a final farewell to politics. Newsweek's cover story calls Clinton the most powerful woman in American history. How's that for an endorsement? So a big farewell in Washington today.
Here's your first look at this morning's dish of scrambled politics. The latest Gallup poll finds Americans still don't like Congress very much. Only 15% approve of the job that lawmakers are doing. That's up 1 point from last month. The second-ranking Democrat in the House, Maryland Congressman Steny Hoyer, says in his opinion, the 2016 presidential race is easy to predict. He says if Hillary Clinton decides to run, she would clear the field and, quote, I don't know that anybody would run against Hillary.
Up next, it's week one of retirement for now, and she's still voted most popular.